Today we got something exciting and very practical. I will be going through how you can build a website with a lot of assistant from AI tools. This is going to be a three-part series, but the good news is all episodes are available now. So sit back and enjoy. Let's get going. Okay, so let's just start by talking a few words about why you should build a website in the first place. So I think today, if you want to do some business, if you have something like an organization or anything, you kind of need a website, don't you? People expect that. So people might think it's hard to build a website, but it's quite easy actually if you just know the steps. So with the AI, it's even easier. So that's what I'm going to show you today. There's a lot you can look here. Like, this is just my YouTube channel website. It gets a lot of traffic after just a few weeks, so it's working as intended. So you can monetize different kind of websites in different kind of ways. You can just make a website just to make money, do like a blog with informational content and put ads on and make money. Or you can have website as a service. So that's the reason behind this video, actually. Okay, so the first thing we kind of need when we are going to start a website is a topic, of course. So for this video, I have chosen the topic artificial general intelligence. It's quite a fitting topic, isn't it? So when we have our topic, what we need next is what I call semantically related topics. We want to write about AGI, of course, but we also want some related topics. So what I'm going to show you now is how you can easily use GPT-3 to find these semantically related topics. Because since GPT-3 has already knows a lot about Google search and how a website shows up, we can just use that to find related topics. Okay, so now we are on the playground on the GPT-3, and you can see I have typed in, "You are an expert Google search SEO with the knowledge of Google search algorithm, and you are a digital marketing expert." That is what I'm just telling the engine. And the question I'm going to ask now is, what does Google think? Google search think is semantically related to the topic artificial general intelligence. Then I'm just going to hit submit. And it comes up with Google search considered semantically related topics to AGI include things like machine learning, deep learning, natural language processing, and AI. So I'm not going to take AI, but I think we're going to do machine learning, deep learning, and NLP. I think that's three good semantically related topics to start off with. So while we are at it, I want GPT-3 to give me image IDs and prompts we can use for our images for the web page. So here I have given GPT-3 three different examples of the style I want the prompts to be in. So what I want to do now is get it to write five more similar topic image examples. So let's see what it comes up with. Okay, so this looks a bit different. So I think we are happy with these. So we're going to use this. I think it's going to be in the next episode to create our images in Midjourney and Stable Diffusion. So now we have our topic. We have some image IDs. So next thing I want to do is, of course, we need a domain for our website. I've already gone and bought a domain. So I'm going to show you what our domain is going to be. Superstrongai.com. So that is our domain. I think I paid, it's like $4 from GoDaddy.com for the first year. I don't know if this website's going to stay up, but we'll see. Anyway, that's quite cheap. And since this is going to be a WordPress site, we also need a host. So I always use Cloudways. This is cloud-based, of course. So it's going to be pay-as-you-go. It's a small price. I think since I got an own server, it's not going to cost me anything else. But if you want to buy a server, it can range for like, I'm around $15 a month. So it's not that bad. You have some free alternatives on the cloud, like Azure and AWS, if you want to explore that. I'm not going to do that in this video, but anyway, that is our website domain name and our host. That was part one done, so check out part two here, where we will create content and images with GPT-3, Midjourney, and Stable Diffusion. We will also set up our WordPress website, so I'll see you over there.